Okay, so let's continue our lessons on chapter 13, okay, in your textbook. Okay, maybe you may wonder why we continue our lessons on chapter 13. Before this, we already learned chapter 7, okay, maybe chapter 6 and chapter 7, and now it jumps to chapter 13. Okay, this is all due to the syllabus, okay, that the syllabus that we program so that you will have a good transition in terms of learning good I mean learning a good way and how to improvise your understanding in terms of simple harmonic motions, okay, because it's all related to the one that we already learned, which is the Hooke's law. Okay, maybe as all of you have already doing already did the experiments of Hooke's law, so this might help you in terms of understand the concept, the true concepts of simple harmonic motion. So let's I will share my slides first. Okay. Okay, this is simple harmonic motions. Maybe in your syllabus and maybe in your lesson plan, you will look at the oscillations and wave. Okay, this is the same topics as oscillations and wave. So what should we learn in the oscillations and wave? Okay, we will learn some things that related to periodic motions. Okay, the simple harmonic motions. Okay, the connection between circular motion and the simple harmonic motions, the period of mass on the spring, and the energy conservation in oscillatory motions, and also the simple pendulum. Okay, the pendulum. Okay, so we'll look further out. All right, so what is the periodic motions? Okay, a motion that repeats itself over and over again. So that means, okay, if you notice something, some motion that repeating, okay, repeating against time, so that is called periodic motions. Okay, periodic motions. Okay, and the one that we should relates to the periodic motion is what we call as period. Okay, period. Okay, period means a capital T. Okay, it's not the same as time. Time is T, a small letter T. So this is time taken. However, the period is the time required for one cycles of periodic motions. Meaning that if you want to complete one cycles, so that requires some time. Right? Require some time that should be that what we call what we call that as period. Okay, so time required for one cycles of periodic motion. So that's why when we talk about period, okay, the other terms that should relate to period is called frequency. Okay, frequency is F, okay, the capital the small letter F, that is reciprocal of the period. Okay, meaning that if you do have period, then you want to find what is the frequency, then you should divide. Okay. The period is one, the frequency is one over period. Okay, of course, this will give you S negative one, meaning that over second, because period is the unit of seconds, and frequency is the unit of second negative one. But the second negative one is also known as hertz. Okay, meaning that one hertz is equivalent to one cycle per 1 second. Okay, so this is what we call as periodic motions. Okay, so let's look at the examples here. Okay, a good examples. Okay, let's say 1,300 kilograms of car constructed on a frame supported by four springs. Okay, if you have springs, so each spring has a spring constant. Okay, this one. Okay, if you notice in the question, now we have 1,300. This is a mass. Okay, and is supported by four springs. Let's say a very big spring that contain a spring constant. Okay, I have K. Right, so it's about 20,000 newton per meter. Okay, if two people riding in the car have a combined mass of 160 kilogram, find the frequency of vibrations of the car when it is driven over a pothole in the road. Find also the period. Okay, now we have to underline the frequency. You want to find what is the frequency. We also, when we have a frequency, we can find period and the angular frequency. What is angular frequency, class? Omega. Okay, omega. Omega is angular frequency. In this case, okay, that normally we assume that angular omega is actually also known before this as angular speed. But in this chapter, angular speed, okay, we can call that as angular frequency. Okay, I'll show you why afterwards. Okay, okay. So what is 1/4? Okay, so look at the problem here. We have four springs that can support a 1,300 car, and together with the people, okay, riding the car. So that's why here we have a mass of a car and mass of the passenger. Okay, so we add up to, in order to that we can have a 1/4. Okay, you can see that 1/4. Why? Because one spring, okay, is equivalent to 1/4 of the mass. Okay, one spring, okay, have been divided. Okay, all total masses now have been divided into four. Okay, so that the equivalent is equal the one part. Okay, one part of the spring will fill 365 kilogram. Okay, 365 kilogram, and then of course, okay, the frequency is 1/T. Okay, and also we don't have T. Okay, we don't have period, so that's why we have to find F. And just remember, we have not learned yet. Okay, the equations of frequency other than 1/T. Okay, so let's put this on hold first, and then we continue to look at the frequency. Because you may find that this frequency have a different meaning, because what we learn, we already learned in the first slide, the frequency is 1/T. Okay, 1/T, 1/period, but not is equivalent to 1/2π, a square root of k over m. So in order to understand why frequency is also equivalent to this part, okay, the one on the right, 1/2π square of k over m. You can look here, k is the spring constant, m is the mass, and 2π is 2π, right? It's this constant value. And how can we define f equals to 1/2π and square root k over m? So in order to understand this part, okay, we should learn further. Okay, now, all right, okay. So this part is called simple harmonic motion. Okay, in order for us to understand the questions before this, so we need to understand first what is the simple harmonic motion. Okay, the simple harmonic motion is actually comes from the repeating, okay, a periodic motion repeating over and over again. When it comes to the elastic things, okay, when you do have elastic things and the motion repeating it over and over again, so that's what we call a simple harmonic motion. Okay, in this case, if you look at this part, okay, the figures on your right or on your left, okay, you can see, or try, can you imagine that you have a big, you have a spring. Okay, what happened is the spring, if we don't pull anything or we don't push, it falls on the equilibrium position. So this is what we call equilibrium position. Okay, that means the position where the spring doesn't have any external force, so you don't have to pull or push, so you just let the springs as it is. So that's what we call as equilibrium position. Okay, kita biarkan saja equilibrium position. Okay, so what happened is if you try to pull, okay, to pull the masses, okay, in this case you try to bring, okay, you try to bring the object, okay, at the spring, okay, at a certain displacement. Okay, this is what we call displacement. Okay, to be exact, this is a maximum displacement. Okay, meaning that you can pull the object to your right. Okay, let's say the spring is on the air track, which doesn't have, which is a frictionless track. Okay, and you pull the object to your right, and then you hold it first, and that is what we call maximum displacement. Okay. What happened is if you release the object, when you release the object, so here, okay, you pull at this point and you hold it first and say this is V equals to zero. Okay, V equals to zero, and then afterwards you release the object. So what happened is you can see the object will move. Okay, definitely will move. Okay, that's why look at the P part. Okay, it will move to your left, or to be exact, it will move to the opposite side, okay, to the opposite side as what you already try to bring the original position. Okay, let's say in part A you want to bring this object to your right. Okay, then you pull it to the right, and afterwards you can look at the situation where the object will move to your left. Okay, will move to your left because of the elastic things, or should we call as restoring force. Why restoring force? Okay, that is involved. Restoring force involve elastic things. Okay, elastic. Well, what does it mean by elastic? Elastic means it wants to return to its original position. Okay, return to its original position. So, when you pull the things to your right, you want to go to the left. If you try to push the object to your left, then the object wants to return to its original position to your right. So that's what it means by restoring. So that's why a spring exerts, okay, as mentioned in the statements there, a spring exerts a restoring force. Okay, and the equations for restoring force is F equals to negative kx, which means F is the amount of force, the amount of force, and x is the elongation. This is a force. X is the elongation. Pemanjangan ataupun pengurangan, elongations, and K is the, obviously is the spring constant. This place is the spring constant. That is proportional to the displacement of the displacement of from the equilibrium. So you can see here, okay, this one is not five objects. This is actually just one object. Okay, you must do it properly. You must understand this figure. This figure represent one object only. The object is only in part A. When you try to pull the object to your right, and then you release it back, you release and afterwards the spring is considered elastic things that may have a restoring force, that it forced the object to move to its original position. So that's why the object will move. Does it stop at the equilibrium position? I think so, but not in the case of this restoring force, because when you see the object that you release from V from point A, from X equals to A, then what happened is it will move to its equilibrium position. Does it stop there? No, because of the inertia that we already learned in the Newton's first law. Okay, that is equal due to the inertia, then it will still move it. Okay, still move to the X equals to negative A. which also means the maximum displacement, but in the negative direction. Okay, so it still move here and it move back to the equilibrium position at point D, and lastly it'll still move, it's still getting at the same point that it was released. So this is what we call a complete oscillation. Okay, when the object, okay, move from its original positions, okay, not equilibrium, original position, then you release, then it goes back to what, to where you release, where you, it was released earlier. So that is considered one complete oscillation. Okay, one complete oscillation. So this motion have been presented to your for your understandings to the graph on your right. Okay, for the graph on your right, so you can see when you pull at point A, when you pull the objects to your right, okay, and then you hold it first, so V equals to zero. So this is point where you have a maximum displacement. Okay, maximum displacement. Then when you release, okay, you can see here. So this is where a point B. Okay, and afterwards it goes here. So this is where the point C, and it goes back to point D. Where is point D? Here. Okay, and afterward goes back to point D. So you can see this and it will repeat back. Okay, it just not stop there. Okay, it will repeat until it comes to the end, and maybe the loss of its energy, and then it will stop. But definitely, okay, it still move. Okay, it will repeat again and again. So that's what we call as his HHM, simple harmonic motions. So the maximum displacement A is called amplitude. Okay, A is called amplitude. So when we try to plot a graph of x versus time, so when you plot x versus time, so you may have a sinusoidal graph. So this is what we call as sinusoidal graph. What is sinusoidal graph? The graph that repeat again and again. Okay, that means you can see a graph that may have true or crest like this. So this is what we call sinusoidal graph. Okay, so you already learned in your, I believe that you already learned in the admats, during your admats subject, during your secondary school. So you will learn that sinusoidal graph may represent some mathematical equations. Okay, so in this case, this graph considered as cosine graph. Okay, cosine graph. Okay, we also have a sine graph. We also have a tangent graph. So this is the equation, the sinusoidal graph represented by the situation for the spring is actually a cosine graph. Okay. So this is a sine of cosine graph. Like I said, this is the cosine graph. Okay, if we call the period of motion, so look at where we should find the period. The period is actually from crest to crest, daripada atas kepada atas, which means one complete oscillation. This is considered one complete oscillations. Okay, so one complete oscillation may have a certain time. Okay, so this is time T1 and T2. So T2 minus T1 is delta T. Okay, when we divide this one to the one complete oscillation, so we may have frequency. So this is what I mean by frequency, a time required for one complete oscillations. Okay, the time required one complete oscillation is actually period, but 1 over period is considered as frequency. So frequency is 1 over with the units of hertz. So that's how can we assume that the frequency comes from the periodic motion. So remember, so before this we learned F equals to negative kx, but normally we only use F equals to kx. So how about negative? Okay, as I said, negative is actually represent That's what we call restoring force. Okay, itu maksud negatif. Okay, the negative is actually a restoring force. What is restoring force? So when you want to pull the objects to the right, to the left, it wants to go to the right. When you try to pull the object to the right, it wants to go to the left. Always opposing the motion. The motion. That's why the negative is here. Okay, but it doesn't involve when you try to calculate during your any problems or any exercise. Okay, you don't have to put the negative. Okay, don't have to put the negative. The negative is just mean by restoring force. Okay, so we can write the positions as a function of time that is equivalent to x. So this is what we learn. Okay, in the simple harmonic motion, we should learn that the motions that we already look before this. Okay, the periodic motions can be represented by some equation. Okay, can be represent some equation. So look at here. Okay, look carefully. So this is the equations that involve x. Okay, so x is what? Displacement. X is displacement, and if you look at this, is x equals to a. So what is a? A is considered as amplitude. What is amplitude? Maximum displacement. Okay. So remember, so x is displacement, meaning that this is general displacement involve a. And how about cos? Cos is why? Because this graph represent a sine curve, a cos graph, okay? Cos sine graph. So it represent a cos 2 pi over t times t. Okay, I will try to do it properly here. So a cos 2 pi over period times time. Okay, so remember a is amplitude, cos. Why we need to put cos? Because this is the cos sine graph. Okay, cos sine graph. So how to know this is a sine or cosine graph? So when the graph starts at the amplitude, okay, when the graph starts at the maximum value, this is what we mean as cosine graph. If the graph starts at zero, so this is a sine graph. Okay, however, that's how you differentiate between sine and cosine graph. But remember, it's just a matter of how it starts. Okay, the difference is when at the starting points only. Okay, when the starting point, when the graph starts at the maximum value, it means the graph is a cosine graph. However, when the graph starts at zero, so that is mean by sine graph. But if you look at the rest of the graph, it's just a sinusoidal graph. Okay, so we may know, is it a cos or sine just because of the starting point? Okay, the rest of the graph is just the same. Okay, all right. So that is the equation. Look at the equation again. X equals to a cos 2 pi over t times t. Okay, differentiate between t and t. T here is time taken, and this one is period. Okay, remember, period and time taken is not the same. It's not the same terms, because time taken is defined, but you need to calculate time. But period is time for one complete oscillation. Okay, remember, period is T, capital T, and T, small letter T, is time taken. So time taken is just a normal time. Okay, when you do a experiment of Hooke's law before this, okay, or maybe a simple harmonic motion before this, okay, you take the time using your stopwatch. The stopwatch is the time taken. Okay, the period is something else, right? So that's why we are x a cos 2 pi over t times t. Okay, this is one good example. Okay, I may we try to discuss one examples here. An air track cut. Okay, air track means the linear cut that have a lot of holes. Okay, a lot of small holes that can project some air so that the the IB, yeah, this is a track, yeah, hole, so yeah, it will project some air, okay, from the machines, and then this is the mass, okay, it's like a V mass, and it will move, okay, and it will move, okay, when we switch on the air track, okay, this one it will project air, so that the object doesn't the object will slide without any frictions, okay, so that is what meant by air track. So the air track car attached to a spring completes one complete acceleration. So why we need to do as air track? Because we want to reduce, we want to eliminate. Okay, eliminate friction. Okay, attached to a spring completes one oscillation every 2.4 seconds. Every 2.4 seconds. So one complete one completes one oscillation every 2.4 seconds. So definitely this one is period. Okay, because one oscillation every 2.4 seconds, so that is considered as period. At time t equals to zero, and the car is released from rest at a distance of 0.1. Okay, the car t equals to zero, the car is released from rest. Okay, from rest at a distance of 0.1 meters from its equilibrium position. So release at a distance. So meaning that, okay, we should pull the car at 0.1 accordingly, lebih kurang 10 centimeters. Okay, and we hold and then we release. So that's what we mean by A. Okay, or amplitude from its equilibrium position. What is the positions of the car at 0.3 seconds, 0.6 seconds, 2.7 seconds, and 3.0 seconds. So this, okay, what is the positions? Position means we want to find. So the equation now we have x equals to a cos 2 pi over t times t. Okay, so we need to find what is x by changing t. So this is 0.3, okay, 0.6, 2.7, and 3.0 seconds. So we need to find that. And obviously, period is or is equivalent to 2.4 seconds. Okay, 2.4 seconds. But remember, okay, remember, when you use this equation, okay, x equals to a cos, okay, 2 pi over t times t. Okay, this one is, okay, you need to define this part. Okay, this part must be done in the radian mode. Okay, must be done in the radian mode. Okay, the cos, the cos when you times with a doesn't matter because a is just a number. Okay, but the cos, the bracket cos, you need to do it here. That's it. You must to do. You must. So the easiest way when you see the equations, okay, when you want to use the equations, remember to put your calculator in the radian mode, because you need to calculate it in the radian mode, or else you will find the equations and the value is wrong. Okay, to get it right, change it to your substitute it to the radian mode, and then you may find this value. So you can try it out. Okay, can you 0.7 centimeters and zero? So you may see the difference between using a radian mode and the degree mode. And you can see when you can get 7.1 centimeter or 0.071 meters, okay, is actually equivalent to a radian. A okay, radian times 0.1, okay, and again, That's how you solve the problems using A cos 2 pi over T. Okay? Alright, so let's look at the connections between uniform circular motion and simple harmonic motions. So this is very good examples. Okay, right. So before this, we learn x. Okay, the equation is x equivalent to a cos 2 pi over t times t. So this is the original equation, 2 pi over period times t. Right. So this is what we call as positions. So when referring to the rotating turntable, omega is called the angular speed. Okay, when you have a system, let's say the CD part, okay, when you try to move the CDs around, so you may see we can have a different position. Okay, we can have a different position, and the one that we did 2 pi over period is actually equivalent to omega. Okay, before this, we learn omega as angular speed. In this chapter, omega is called angular frequency. Why? Why is it different between angular speed and angular frequency? It's just the same thing, they're the same value, but can you see, when we talk about 2 pi over t, remember one thing, okay? 2 pi times with 1 over t. What is 1 over t? 1 over period is what? It's considered as 2 pi frequency. So that's why omega is equivalent to 2 pi f. Okay? 2 pi f, so 2 pi frequency. So itulah sebabnya the omega is also known as angular frequency. Okay, so don't get confused between angular speed and angular frequency. It's just the same thing. Because before this, we already learned rotational motions. Okay, rotational motion. Okay, omega is considered angular speed. But because of the purpose of this chapter, okay, we learn about equation, the new equation, a cos 2 pi over period times t. So remember, 1 over period is equivalent to frequency. So therefore, 2 pi f is considered as omega. Okay? All right. So the one that we did just now, before this, x equivalent to a cos 2 pi over period times t. A times t. Now we have x equivalent to a cos omega t. Simpler. A cos omega t. And of course, when you talk about sine negative 1, the value of sine negative 1, the unit is still the same. Okay, you can see that the unit is still radian per second. Okay, radian per second because it is a angular speed. Okay, so because angular speed and angular frequency is just different in terms, but this is the same omega. The same omega as rotational motion, so therefore the unit is still radian per second, or we may write it as second negative one. Okay, as a second negative one. Why? Because when you do omega equals to 2 pi over period, okay, 2 pi doesn't have equations, doesn't have units, but period have a unit, so that's why the unit still second negative one or 2 pi radian per second. Okay. Right. So, in order to understand simple harmonic motion, it's very easy because simple harmonic motion is just a motion but repeating. Okay. Motion but repeats it again and again. So, from x, okay, we want to find what is v, and later on we will find that v can be find what is it. Okay, so this is the motion. Obviously, kalau kita belajar apa-apa pun, the motion must start from the position. Okay, and it goes to velocity and afterwards accelerations. Okay, so the velocity of an object in a uniform circular motion is V equals to R omega. Is it, am I right? Obviously, V is the linear speed. R is radius and omega is the angular speed or maybe angular frequency. All right, so how to get, now we have x, okay, x equivalent to a cos omega t, and how can we change this equation into v? Okay, remember one thing. Okay, x is actually you are getting x where you have sorry, it, you are getting v by d over dt. Okay, meaning that you need to do some differentiation. Okay, differentiate the equation of x against time. Okay, differentiate equations of x against time so you can get v, right? So how to do it? Very easy. Okay, let me do some explanations here. Okay, how to do a simple differentiations, right? We want to get these things, okay? Our approach is how to get V equals to A omega sine omega T, okay? Because we already have X equivalent to A cos omega T. So we need to differentiate it. So how to differentiate it? So V is actually D A cos omega T divided by dt. So very easy. A first, try to bring A first. A, because we need, in this case, we have A, okay? We have A and we have cos omega T. So meaning that we should differentiate A and we have to do a partial differentiations. But in the end, what happened is, when you differentiate, A is just it's just a constant value. So we just take it A differently, okay? And how to differentiate cos? Cos and the thing, so we have cos, okay? We have to differentiate cos against time. How to differentiate cos? When you differentiate cos, you are actually getting a negative sign, okay? Negative signs omega t. So this is one, okay? So remember, differentiate cos, cos something is actually negative sign something. Okay, you differentiate cos, you will get negative sign. And then afterwards, you differentiate some, because this is against time. So we differentiate omega t, so you will get omega. Because this is the one that be in front of the time. Okay, maksudnya dia duduk di depan time. So that's it. So in the end, we will have negative A omega sine omega T. Okay. Again, this is A cos omega T against time. So A, right? Negative sine. How to get negative sine is actually, you can imagine this one. Cos theta. Cos something. Something mean cost bracket. So differentiate cost bracket, so you will dapat, you will getting negative sign bracket. So what is the bracket? Omega t, omega t. But remember, this is against time. Okay, against time means the one that have time is actually the one in the bracket. So what is in the bracket? Omega t. So how to differentiate omega t against time? So you will be getting omega out of it. So this is how you getting omega. So when you try, so this one is v. Okay, v is equivalent to negative e omega sine omega t. Right? So you can see here that the graph of x, okay, this is x equals to a cos omega t. And then the green color is actually v equals to negative a omega sine omega t. The equation, you look at the equation as two parts, okay? What happens in the, at the front of the trigonometry function? So this is a trigonometry function. Sine omega t is considered a trigonometry function. So the trigonometry function, we may have a maximum value. The maximum value for trigonometry function is 1. So can you imagine when you obtain 1 inside the bracket, inside the trigonometry functions, so we actually getting maximum, okay, maximum value. So if for example x max will be only a. Why a? Because what's in the behind or what's in the rest of the equation becomes 1, so times 1. How about v max? V max is actually negative a omega times 1. Okay, because this one is actually a cos omega t. This one have sine omega t. So all the trigonometric functions, when it is the maximum value, become 1. Okay, remember, yeah? All the trigonometric function for the rest of the equations, okay, have become 1. So what's left is v equals to negative a omega, and a at x equals to a. Yeah, obviously the maximum displacement is obviously still amplitude. So sebab tu kita dapat amplitude is a maximum displacement. Okay, all right. So let's look at the acceleration. The accelerations are causing by, so we need to find the acceleration. Acceleration, I think we need to do a dv over dt. So from the dv over dt, from the velocity, okay, you need to differentiate against time in order to get acceleration. How to do it? All right, again, what is v? V is equivalent to negative a omega, sorry, negative a omega sine omega t. Negative a omega sine omega t. So right now, we need to do it like the one. So what is a? A is dv over dt. So how to get it? So the one that be in front, just put it in. And how about the trigonometry function? Ingat, sine omega t is sine something. Sine something, okay, kita differentiate dia dapat cos something, cos omega t, and cos omega t. And we need to differentiate the one in the bracket, the bracket, not the semicolon, not the colon, is omega. So we need to differentiate it again to get omega. So that's why we get negative E omega square cos omega T. Okay. So the one that I teach you just now about differentiate, okay, how to get V, how to get E with the differentiation is for those who doesn't want to memorize the equations. But if you can memorize the equation, then it doesn't have to do a differentiation, because there will be no questions on how to get the value of A or V using the differentiation. Okay, so if you trying to memorize the value, because the one that be given inside your appendix, okay, appendix for your final, is just A like this, A max equals to A omega squared. Okay, it doesn't give you A equals to negative A omega square cos omega t. Doesn't do that way. Okay, remember, the one that in the appendix doesn't give you like this. Yang ni tak ada. Yang ada hanyalah like this. What is A max? What is V max? So maksudnya yang bahagian depan ni je dia bagi. Dia tak bagi yang belakang-belakang. So in order for us to understand, we need to know. Because maybe there will be some questions that relating the time. Okay. So the velocity as a function of time is V equals to negative A omega sine omega t. And the acceleration is A equals to negative A omega cos omega t. So if you look at the equations. Okay. So this is X. What is X? X equals to A cos omega t. Okay, what is A? A is what? Is negative A omega square cos omega t. Okay, by looking at the equation itself, you may understand why. Okay, look at here. Okay, V is negative A omega sine omega t. Look at the equations and look at the graph. Graph of the green graph, okay, starting from zero. Okay, why starting from zero? Because this is the sine graph. Sine graph starts at zero. Okay, dia bermula dekat kosong, starts at zero. X lain, X cos sine graph. X ialah cos graph. So cos graph dia bermula dekat value. So V graph dia bermula dekat kosong. It starts at zero, so it is a sine graph. So it's still a sinusoidal graph, and if you look carefully, it starts at zero and it goes down to the negative amplitude first. So that's why in here we get V equals to negative A omega sine omega t. Okay, negative A. So that's why it means ke bawah dulu. Dia bukan positif. Sama juga dengan acceleration. Okay. What is V? V is actually negative A omega square. A is actually negative A omega square. But what is the situation now? This is a cos graph. So cos graph A starts at the amplitude. Okay, it doesn't start at zero. So, sama je macam X, tetapi dia start daripada negatif. Yeah? It starts at the below part, which is the negative part. Okay, the negative cos omega t. So, now you already learn X, you already learn V and A. So, we may find this is the velocity as a function of time, which contain negative A omega sine omega t. Remember, this part, it must be done in the radian mode together with this one. Radian mode. So this is V, this is A omega, and negative A omega. So this one is the maximum value. Okay, So when did the velocity and acceleration, and maybe so I will write down as x equals to a cos omega t. So cos omega t, the one in the big bracket is radian mode. Okay. So you can find, say, whatever I circle it, that one is considered the maximum value. Okay. So whenever you have x, v, and a in maximum value, the one in the bracket is considered as one. Okay. So this one have x equals to a maximum. So a maximum ialah a omega squared. Okay. You may find a negative, you may write down as a negative a omega squared pun boleh. V a omega. Okay. Remember a omega and a omega squared. That is the maximum value for each terms. Okay. So this is how the difference between x, v. Okay, this is x, this is v, and this is a acceleration. Okay. Try to look and try to define. Try to look at the different places where and where. Now, okay, let's look at the examples here. Okay. Or maybe you want to go back to the original one, this one. Okay. Oh, it's not yet. But we know some things that F omega is actually 2 pi F. Okay. So can we define F? Yes. So F is what as omega divided by 2 pi. What is omega? Okay. So let me look further afterwards. Okay. Not yet. Now try to understand this one. Examples 13.2. Okay. So in the examples 13.1, okay, before this, okay, we already did the part where we need to define, we need to calculate x, okay, as a different time. Okay, different time, but this one, okay, will have the same period, 2.4 seconds, t equals to zero. Okay, period, this is t. The cut released from rest with the spring stretch is 0.1. This one is considered as a. What are the velocity and acceleration of the cut at 0.3 seconds and 0.6 seconds? Okay, so first thing first, you need to do calculations of omega. Omega equals to 2 pi F. So if the question doesn't have F, then we can use T. So that's why we are getting 2.6 radian per second. Okay, so you can replace this one, 2.6 second. Okay, it's just the same thing. So V equals to negative A omega sine omega T. And again, using the same concept, okay, the one in the bracket should be calculated in radian mode. Okay, the one in the bracket should be calculated in radian mode, not this thing, okay, this one, okay, the big the sine of in the bracket, or the trigonometric function must be calculated in the radian mode. So in that case, you can find the value in terms of leading. Okay. Okay. So you can do this part. Okay, you can calculate it on your own. Try to do it. Okay. Try to get the feelings of how to calculate each term. Okay, each term to and in order to get 18 centimeter per seconds, and the rest of the A. Okay, V and A and also V and A for 0.3 seconds and 0.6 seconds. If you look carefully, 0.3 seconds, V is 18 centimeter per seconds, and A is negative 48 centimeter per second square. Look at the value, eh? And obviously for For V equals to 0.6 seconds, okay, you get negative 26. And for the A, you will get in 0. Why 0? So, because of the cos 90, okay, because it's pi over 2. Okay, so remember to do in the bracket, you must do it radian. Okay, let's look at the other examples. A turbulence. Okay. On December 29, 1997, a United Airlines flight from Tokyo to Honolulu was hit with a severe turbulence 31 minutes after a takeoff. Okay. Data from the airplane's black box indicated the 2747 move up and down. Move up and down, okay, with an amplitude of 0.3 meters. Okay, sorry, 30 meters. 0.1, 30 meters. So normally the flight will only move like this and straight, but with the turbulence, okay, it goes down, up and down, okay, up and down, naik ke atas turun. So bila dia masa dia naik ke atas tu, maksimum dia adalah 30 meters daripada original. Ni original dia. Okay, this is the equilibrium. The line of equilibrium. So this one is called A. Ialah A. And the maximum acceleration of 1.8 g, 1.8 gravity. So meaning that the persons inside the 747 plane may feel 1.8 times gravity. Okay, the gravity we know is 9.8, so you times with 1.8. So maybe the increase in the gravity. Treating the up and down motions of the plane as a simple harmonic, find the time required for one complete oscillation. So part A, they want to find what is period, and part B, the plane's maximum vertical speed. Okay, so in order to do that, all right, so we may find that A omega squared, okay, A omega squared, A max, okay, A equals to A omega squared. Remember how I'm getting this one? It essentially comes from A equals to negative A omega squared cos omega t, but for the rest of the part, the rest of the trigonometric functions now have becomes one. Why one? Because in there, this is the position where the maximum, okay, the position where the maximums, so A is actually A omega squared. So what is omega squared? So omega here is equivalent to A max divided by A square root. Okay, A max divided by A square roots, or we may write down as omega equals to 2 pi over t. Okay, so okay, 2 pi over t equals to square root of A max over amplitude. Okay, so when you take this thing up, this thing becomes at the bottom. Now it becomes t equals to 2 pi square root of, sorry, divide by square root of A max over A, like this. Okay, so the A max is 1.8 g gravity times with, so when you do the calculations, make sure it's 9.8, not 9.81. So amplitude is 30 meters. So you may find that the period is actually 8.2 seconds. Okay, 8.2 seconds. And how about V max? Okay, V max in the last question, the plane's maximum vertical speed. Okay, so V max again is A omega. Why I'm getting this one? This comes from V equals to negative A omega sine omega t. The sine omega t becomes one. Okay, so it just left A omega. Okay, so now I'm getting 223 meter per seconds. Okay, so This is another examples 13.6. Okay, find the amplitude, frequency, and period of motions for an object vibrating at the end of the horizontal springs if the equation for its position as a function of time is like this. Okay, so now you have x equals to 0.25 meters, cos pi over 8t. Now remember, so this is x. So right now you need to do some matching in terms of, because now it's getting x equals, you give you just a number. Okay, so you need to remember that x is actually a cos omega t. So now you know what is a. It's 0.25. What is omega? Omega is pi over 8. And the rest of it is just the same. Okay, so find the amplitude frequency. So what is amplitude? Amplitude is 0.25. Okay, so you must properly did the matching, because you need to match the one that be in front of the cos must be A. Okay, so that's why it's a maximum displacement amplitude frequency comes from the omega. Omega is equal to 8 over 8, like this, 2 pi f. So you need to do f over omega over 2 pi, so you may find 0.0625 hertz. Okay, 0.0625 hertz. So period is 1 over frequency. Remember, frequency is 1 over period, and period can also reciprocal of 1 over frequency. The same things. Okay, it can goes back to this one. So that is equivalent to 16 seconds. Okay. And part B, find the maximum magnitude of the velocity and acceleration. Okay, Vmax and Amax. Again, what is Vmax? Vmax is A omega. And what is Amax? A omega squared. So you already have A, you already have omega. Okay, this is omega. Okay, you put it here, and you will find. Look at the unit. The unit used is the linear. Okay, meaning that you need to meter per second and meter per second squared. Alright, so the one that I want you to highlight here is the one at point C. What are the position, velocity, and acceleration of the object after 1 second has elapsed? 1 second has elapsed. Okay, remember, when you want to find maximum position, maximum velocity, maximum acceleration, we just use the equation, the normal equation. So x now a, v ialah a omega, a ialah a omega squared now. But in part C, it involves time. Okay, when it involves time, you need to use the original equation. What is original equation? Like this. This is A, this is B, and this is A, because the question, what are the position? Position is the one is 0.25, right? Two points elapsed. So this is x is A cos omega t. Doesn't state here. So at point T, okay, every time you see T, you need to put 1 seconds. You need to times it with 1 seconds. Okay, and then again, we should apply back. Okay, or the one that should we consider these things. Okay, remember to do it. Okay, to put the value in the bracket in radian mode. Obviously, in the radian mode. Okay, remember these things. You must put every value in the bracket in the radian mode, so as you may not find the answers. Okay, so the value should be 0.31 meters, negative 0.0376 meter per seconds. You look at the unit, okay, and A is negative 0.0357 meter per seconds squared. Okay, it's very good examples. Okay, these examples is discussed in your textbook. Okay, look at this kind of examples. Okay, so this is the period of a mass on a spring, okay? The period of a mass on a spring. So how to get the period of a mass on the spring? Okay, we know the spring contains elastic things. So elastic things normally will have a restoring force. And of course, the restoring force will create a simple harmonic motion when it oscillates. Okay, bila dia oscillate. Right? So, we try to bring F. Okay, we know that F from the Hooke's law, F equals to negative Kx. And remember, in the Newton's second law, okay, no, we need to do some, we can also define F as F equals to Ma. So Ma equal to negative Kx. So Ma equals to negative Kx. So these things. Right? So what is A in terms of simple harmonic motion? Remember, A is what? It is negative A omega squared cos omega t, negative K A cos omega t. Both of the sides have cos omega t. So we may have to, we can actually X A dengan A potong, cos dengan cos potong, yang ni pun potong. Tinggal siapa je yang tinggal. Okay. So you may find that the one that be left is omega squared equals to K over M. Okay. So lastly, okay, omega equals to square root of K over M. Remember what is omega? Omega is 2 pi over T. And from 2 pi over T, you may have T equivalent to 2 pi M over K. Okay. So this one is just to prove that angular frequency, okay, 2 pi F, okay, angular frequency tadi, angular frequency, or maybe you can write down 2 pi F ataupun 2 pi over T can be, is also equivalent to K over M. Ha, nampak? Omega ni banyak sebenarnya. Banyak dia bila kita boleh write down dia. Satu 2 pi F, satu 2 pi over T, satu lagi square root of K over M. So in the end, okay, we may find the period is equivalent to 2 pi square root of M over K. What is M? Mass. And what is K? Spring constant. Okay, period is 2 pi M over K, mass and spring constant. So this one is a period, okay, at a different period. Okay, so when you increase in the factor of certain things, right? Look at the examples. 0.12 kilogram mass attached to a spring oscillate with an amplitude. Okay, so this one is A. Okay, write down first. Okay, and the maximum speed. So this one is V max. Find A the force constant and B the period of motion. So remember, so A V max ialah A omega. Okay, so from here we can get what? Okay, we can get actually omega equals to V max divided by, so V max dapat A, dapat omega. Omega, remember, omega is square root of K over M, because the question asks you to find what is this force constant. Force constant is K. Okay, kadang-kadang dia panggil spring constant. This one is also known as force constant. And lastly, when you have omega, you may also calculate period. Okay, this is very easy, but you need to know where does it come. Okay, so this one we relates back to the our first equation. Okay, you look at the first examples here. Yes, these things. Okay, find also the period. Okay, find the frequency of vibrations of the current is driven over a pothole. Okay, so F over T. Remember, you can define F as omega as 2 pi F So F equals to 2 pi, sorry, omega over 2 pi. What is omega? Omega equivalent to 1 over 2 pi equivalent to square root of k over m. So in this case, problem solved. So this how it determines the questions. Okay, because we already learned from this part. Okay, so let's move to the next part, which is the energy conservation in the oscillatory motions. Okay, energy conservation in oscillatory motions. We know the energy comes from the total mechanical energy, which means when we talk about energy, it means total energy is equivalent to kinetic plus potential. Okay, kinetic plus potential. And when it comes to spring, potential spring is half kx squared. Okay, so half kx squared and half mv squared. But for the simple harmonic motions, okay, it's quite different things. Okay, because x is now become x a cos omega t. Now what happened here? So in the end, we will have half k a square cos omega square omega t, cos square omega t. Okay, cos square omega t. So with the maximum, this one becomes 1. So that's why the last part is the potential maximum potential energy will be half ka square, and a is the amplitude. Okay, now look at the kinetic energy. So kinetic energy is half mv square. Okay, half mv square. So what is the from the simple harmonic motion, v is equivalent to negative a omega sine omega t. So from this part, okay, it downs to here. So m a omega square sine square omega t, this part have become 1 when it comes to maximum, and the half, the k max will be half m a omega square. You just take the front part. Take the front part. Why I take the front part? Because all the rest of the equations becomes 1 when it comes to the situation where we get the maximum part. So when you have this one is the maximum k potential energy equivalent to maximum kinetic energy. Now it becomes like this. Half Ka equivalent to half Ma squared omega squared. Okay, it's just an equation. So you need to know first, K is half Mv squared, potential is half Kx squared. Okay, it's simple. Okay, but the rest of the story is just how the simple harmonic motion change the terms, from half kx square, now it becomes half ka square. Okay, from half mv square, now becomes half ma square omega square. Actually, it's just a matter of how you want to use the amplitude and omega. That's all. Okay, in this case, potential only have amplitude. For the kinetic energy, okay, have amplitude and omega together. Okay, so don't have to memorize all these things. Just a simple one. Okay, you may have to look at the examples here. Okay, 0.98 kilogram block slides on the frictionless horizontal surface with a speed of v. So this one become v. The block encounters an unstretched spring with a force constant. So this becomes K, as shown in the sketch. How far is the spring compressed before the block comes to rest? So how far? the spring compression. We need to find x, and we need to find amplitude, sorry, amplitude, because we have half mv square, meaning that from the kinetic energy, now it completely becomes potential. So we are getting half ke square. So because half and half we can eliminate. So what's left is the mv squared equals to ke squared. So we need to find what is k. A is equivalent to v, because v we have square m over k. So we put max and you put spring constant. So now you're getting the amplitude is 0.0835. And B, how long is the block in contact with the spring before it comes to rest? Okay, how long is the block in contact with the spring before it comes to rest? Okay, so we need to find the period, okay, from this part, meaning that the time taken for the spring to completely stop is 0, you know, 2 pi m over k. So the value should be equivalent to 0.397 seconds. Now divide by 4. Since the block has been in contact with the spring for 1/4 of an oscillation. 1/4 of an oscillation ni sebenarnya datang daripada mana, eh? Okay. Katalah this one is the equilibrium position, x equals to 0. This one, x equals to negative a. X equals to a. So in order to get the completely stop, so start from 1, 2, balik semula 3, 4. So 1, 2, 3 and 4. So that means you may have 4 motions, 4/4 of motions to have a complete oscillation. That's what we mean by console. So all of this 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4 is considered as 1 complete oscillation, time required from 1. So 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4 is actually period. Okay, so we need to define one part of it. One part is just 0.0993 seconds. Okay, so yeah, I don't want to do this kind of examples. Maybe it's not the right thing, because the examples only involve some representations from mass and k. Okay, but we straight go to the pendulum. Okay, a simple pendulum consists of mass m suspended by string or rod of length l. Okay, simple pendulum. Okay, simple pendulum is something that have mass. So this is mass suspended by a string or rod of length L. Okay, string or rod of length L. So this is L. And the angle it makes with the vertical varies with time as a sine or cosine. So in the end, okay, I don't want to discuss how you are getting the equations, but in the end, okay, that's what it means by here. Okay, I want to highlight here, when you do a simple harmonic motion, remember, simple harmonic motion equation when you do with your friends, I always make sure that the theta, okay, the theta that you want to oscillate the pendulum must not be more than 10 degrees, must be very, very small angle. So this is due to this one, because we want to make sure that the sine theta from the equations, okay, from the equations, maybe from this part, we are getting these things, f equals to mg sine theta, okay, and sine theta, this, if you want to make sure that the theta is really, really small, or in fact, the sine theta now becomes value the theta, itu yang kita nak. So that's why mg sine theta now become mg theta only. And what is theta? Theta is s over l. Okay, so itu yang saya selalu mention. And that's why lastly, okay, we want to eliminate. So from the previous part, T equals to 2 pi M over K. And because of that, K is what? K is Mg over L. So you bring this thing. So we need to define K. And in the end, we will have 2 pi L over G for period. So the period, okay. Now, for the spring, maybe that we should use M over K. Okay, because it contains spring constant. But for the period, for the simple pendulum, okay, we may use L over G, where L is the length of the pendulum. And G is the gravity. It doesn't involve any mass. Mass has now been eliminated, have been cancelled out. So we only use length of pendulum and gravity. So this one, you may see, okay, 2 pi m over k is specifically for spring, and for pendulum, we will use L over G. Okay, so that's how you I want to highlight the period. So the period for springs and the period for pendulum. Okay, so let's look at the examples here. A pendulum is constructed from a string of 0.627 meters long attached to a mass of 0.25 kilogram. When set in motion, the pendulum completes one oscillation every 1.59 seconds. So this should be a period. This should be L, and this should be M. If the pendulum is held at rest and the string is cut, how long will it take for the mass to fall through a distance of 1 meter? Is it something else? Okay, so you need to find first what is T, right? So in the case of the, how long will it take for the mass to fall through a distance of 1 meter? So you know that the time, the period is 2 pi L over G. Square of L over G. So from this part, we know T, we don't have to find what is T, what is 2 pi and L, because everything I've already stated. But this question asks, how long will it take for the mass to fall? Okay, so meaning that we need to find what is T. So how to calculate T? So remember one thing, from the previous chapter, that y equivalent to y naught plus v naught t plus half a t squared. Yeah, a t squared. And y naught 0, v naught rest 0, so y have now become half G T squared. Yeah, I put G instead of A is because of G is gravity, okay? Because we don't have to, because when it falls down, it falls with a free fall, okay? When attached to something else, then it doesn't, it is not a free fall. But when we cut it, the rope, we cut the string, now the pendulum will fall with a free fall, so that's why we can use G. So in this case, we want to find what is in the case of G, and then of course we put G inside here to get T. So T, lastly T will become 0.452 seconds. Okay, right. So a little bit more in terms of physical pendulum, doesn't have much. We may add at the simple pendulum. Look at the words physical pendulum. What is physical pendulum? A mass, a solid mass. Meaning that instead of you are using string, ke, thread, ke, okay, benang, dan sebagainya. But right now you are using some solid things. Okay, let's say you are using a block. Or maybe you are using bone. So this is what we call physical pendulum. Okay, It's not a simple pendulum. So the T cannot be 2 pi L over G for this part. Okay, because this is a physical pendulum. And for this case, it can be shown that the period depends on the moments of inertia. Now, look at the T here. Okay, T is not just 2 pi L over G, but will be influenced by the moment of inertia. Remember, moment of inertia we learned in chapter 7, the rotational dynamics, right? About I. Okay, I, so it involved with this. But I mean, this is just for your understanding only. Okay, that it doesn't apply to your publications. But you need to know the difference between physical pendulum and also simple pendulum. Right? Okay, so I think that should be the end of the chapter 13.